Contempt. Oversight Committee member Representative Trey Gowdy joined us. Good evening, sir.
Yes, ma'am. How are you?
Well, I don't know if you've seen this email. Is that this was 3 months before the story broke. She said in response to something about Organizing for America, she said, oh, maybe I can get a D.C. office job. I don't know if she's flipping funny or if she had, you know, or if she's trying to curry favor. Your thought?
Well, it'd be a whole lot funnier if she wasn't targeting Crossroads at the same time she was, in essence, applying or musing about applying for a job with a left-leaning entity. One of the allegations of Ways and Means is that she violated people's rights under color of law. That's one of the criminal statutes. And the evidence that she targeted Crossroads, which is a conservative advocacy group, frankly, Greta, is overwhelming. And all I've seen is just the letter. But it's overwhelming, for my judgment, that she targeted a conservative group.
Is she going to jail?
You're going to have to ask Attorney General Holder. I will say this. The notion that there is not one smidgen of criminality or corruption, which is what the president told us on Super Bowl Sunday, has been totally debunked by what Ways and Means has done. I have to trust that the career prosecutors are going to look at this seriously. And I think that at least a prima facie case has been made for two separate criminal violations.
You know what? I don't get, I mean, it's got to get around Attorney General Eric Holder. I mean, he can pull the plug on and stop it from there. But when you've got, I mean, look, you've got President Obama saying the smidgen comment that basically that it's over, you know, that there's nothing there. That was in February of this year. And then just today we get this email that she says, maybe I can get a job in the D.C. office job with Organizing for America. I mean, it really is, you know, enough is enough. I mean, I don't know how Eric Holder cannot at least send this to a grand jury for investigation. Maybe there's no criminal involvement, but there sure is enough to send it to a grand jury, or I think there is.
I do, too. And, you know, yesterday there was an exchange between the attorney general and Louie Gohmert where the attorney general made it very clear, at least to me, I was sitting 10 feet away from him, that he did take being held in contempt of Congress seriously. He didn't agree with it. He thought he was treated unfairly, but he took it seriously. Well, hopefully he also takes his legacy as this nation's top law enforcement official seriously. And when you have Ways and Means, I mean, it's one thing to kind of minimize oversight as a bunch of crazy former prosecutors. This is Ways and Means, which is a very well-respected, venerable committee. And they sent three separate referrals to the Department of Justice.
You know, I guess it must frustrate you as a former assistant United States attorney. You know, I can hear in your voice, we've had conversations, that it's just like pulling teeth to try to get information. This is the most frustrating, it's like you can't get the information out of the IRS. And in order for you to get a subpoena, you've got to beg from above. I mean, it's just it's just incredible.
And then you have Commissioner Koskinen saying, we'll get you the emails in a couple of years. I mean, can you imagine if you told a judge that you were going to do something for him or her in a couple of years, or if you sent a grand jury subpoena and the private citizen said, yeah, I'll get around to that when I feel like it. Yes, it is very frustrating. And, I miss my old job, but I'm sure some days you miss your old job, too.
You know, some days I do. That whole business about the emails, if someone drops a subpoena on Fox News Channel, and I've been here 12 years and some change, if you drop and ask for all my emails, a lawful subpoena, I bet that and I'm a big emailer, I bet that Fox could get together all 12 years of my emails and deliver them by 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Oh, at a minimum, they'd have them by the end of the week or you know, maybe worst-case scenario at the end of the month, but nobody would say, I'll get them to you in a couple of years. But, Greta, the problem is whatever remedies or tools that we have at our disposal for ensuring compliance, we won't use. We won't make Koskinen sit there until there's a document produced. We won't make John Kerry sit there until they give us what we want in Benghazi. We have certain tools at our disposal. We just won't use them. And as a former prosecutor, it is frustrating.
Is that leadership? I know you want it, and I know you've tried to think. Is that leadership?
I think if Speaker Boehner were here, he would tell you that he has to weigh and balance a lot of factors that a backbencher from South Carolina does not have to weigh and balance. And I think that's what he would tell you.
Representative, nice to see you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. You